It's on. Yo, what's up YouTube? My name is Axel and today we're going to go over the 5 key tools you need to know in Photoshop CC 2021 to get some cool work done. Let's jump right in. So here we are in Photoshop CC 2021 and we're going to be using a photo of myself as kind of the canvas of using these 5 different tools. So the first tool we're going to jump into is the quick selection tool. So either you can press W on your keyboard or just click right here and you're going to get this brush. And then what this does is as you're selecting, it kind of uses its software to kind of figure out, okay, what can kind of be in this and not. Now keep in mind, it's not going to be perfect because it's the computer kind of picking in and out. I recommend to zoom in and out as you're using the tool to be able to see details that it's missing, and then with the brush making it bigger or smaller to select areas and deselect areas. So the way you select is just pressing down, and then if there's an area that's selected that you don't want to be selected, hold down option and you'll be able to take that out. So you'll see right here, and then you can kind of zoom in a little bit more, keep messing with it. So as you zoom in and you switch over from selecting and deselecting, the computer will be able to kind of pick out what you want a little bit better. Man, that's one good looking Puerto Rican. So now we're gonna hit Command J. Again, like I mentioned earlier, this is not gonna be perfect, but it's a really good tool. And if you spend some time with it, you're gonna be able to get some great results from it. So the second tool I wanna highlight today is the pen tool. So with the pen tool, you're able to control the angles a lot more, get more detail, and it's really up to you more what's in and out of the photo. So the way to get the pen tool, you're gonna press P on your keyboard or go to this little pen tool right here. And what you're gonna wanna do is kind of create an outline around your subject. So once you select the point to start, all you gotta do is kind of outline your person. You go here, so you select the point, and then you hold the anchor down to be able to move it around, right? So we're gonna go here, we're gonna kind of create a corner. If you press down option, then you can go back to either anchor and move it around. So then we're just gonna go in. Sweet, so once you create your whole selection, you wanna go in here, and with 2 fingers, so I'm on Mac, so with 2 fingers, I hold down my trackpad, and I do make selection, and I put the feathering in circle, hit okay, and now you're gonna see this little dotted kind of line around it. That's exactly what you want, and then I hit Command J to duplicate what's in that selection, so in that dotted line. Command J copies that now, and now you have, ta-da! Now you have a cutout of me. So a third tool I want to highlight is the Rectangular Marquee tool. This is more of a fun kind of messing around tool, but you can do some really cool stuff with it. So the Marquee tool is this right here, and either you can click on it or hit M and it's going to highlight it. And then we're just going to pick a selection. Let's go here. And once you have this selected, you can hit Command J, which duplicates the layer. Now you have a cutout of my eyes. So you can create some really cool stuff. So tool number 4 is one of my favorites, the clipping mask. So with this, you can kind of add different textures in a specific section or square or circle, any type of shape, any type of whatever, to be able to kind of focus one thing in one area. So let's bring in some textures. I have this from Unsplash, which is going to open it. So now we have this photo of some texture, and let's say we kind of want to do something where it's a specific area, right? It can be as simple as you're bringing in a circle, and then you have your circle under the texture. That's really important. You want it under, not over, under. And then once this right here, that's your texture. I'm gonna right click, create clipping mask, and now it's only visible in that layer that you linked it with, right? So it can be as simple as that, or you can make it a little bit more complex and add some different tools to it. So let's say we go back and use our marquee tool, right? Press M, we're gonna go here, make sure that I'm selected, and we're gonna duplicate my eyes, and then we're gonna bring the texture over that layer. I'm gonna do a create clipping mask, and now you have it there. So you can create some cool stuff with that. There we go. So the 5th and final tool we're gonna talk about is the text warp tool. So let's say subscribe, open it up, right? And let's just send it right here to the mid. So there's a few ways to get to it, but I'm gonna show you guys the way that I use it constantly, and it's by selecting your text. And then you're gonna hit Command T, and you're gonna go up here to this little arc. So after you hit the arc, you're gonna wanna go up here to warp, hit that little arrow, and you're gonna see all the different options you have. So one I use a lot is the wave, and I love it just because it adds some depth Another one that I use a lot is just flag. So flag and wave are really similar, but with flag, there's less points to kind of hold it in. So it looks a little bit crazier. You can go in here and kind of just create different vibe. With all that being said, make sure you like the video, subscribe, comment below. Did you like the video? Did I miss out on some tools? Are there better tools? Let me know. Comment below. Make sure you subscribe. I'll see you guys next time. Peace.